Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I'm Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 30th video class of DIB, we will study constraint least squares filtering in digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. So in the previous video class, we studied Wiener filter, which is also known as MMSE, that is minimum mean square error filter, or least square error filter, that is LSF. And here we'll be studying constraint least square error filter, that is CLSF. So the name itself suggests the difference between the two filters. Here we'll be imposing some constraint on the least square error filtering, and hence removing the degradation from the image. So constraint means we'll be imposing some restriction or limitation during the filtering that must be satisfied, and hence we'll be obtaining the restored image. So let us start. From the model of image degradation and restoration process, we know that to obtain the undegraded image f of uv, if the noise is not present, then we can directly obtain the undegraded image by using inverse filtering that we have learned in the previous video class. But if the noise is present, in that case we cannot use inverse filtering and we have to use the Wiener filter, which we have learned in the previous video class. But the problem with Wiener filter was that the power spectra of the noise was required to be estimated or known, and when that power spectra of the noise is not available, the Wiener filter was failing. And for this constraint least squares filtering, we do not need the power spectra of the noise for obtaining the output. The Wiener filter or MMSE is not optimal when no information on the power spectra is available. And for Wiener filters, the power spectra of the undegraded image SF and noise SN must be known or assumed. That means we must assume the value of capital K. Whereas the constrained least square filter does not make any assumption about the original image and only makes use of mean and variance of the noise. So the method to improve the Wiener filter is to impose a constraint on the mean square error term. Hence, CLSF is an advanced version of the Wiener filter, where we do not need the knowledge of SF and SN, and some constraint is added to the least square filtering. So this also works like Wiener filter, but you can say it is an advanced version of the Wiener filter, right? The CLSF algorithm yields optimal result for each image to which it is applied. From the degradation model, we know that the degraded image g of xy is equal to undegraded image f of xy convolution of the degradation function h of xy, that can be blur or artifacts, plus n of xy, which is the noise. So this equation can be written in the matrix form like this: g is equal to hf plus n, where the matrix dimensions are the dimensions of the corresponding terms. And the issue over here is to find the sensitivity of h to n, that is blur to the noise. And to solve this issue, we provide a constraint to the smoothing by using the Laplacian operator, that is second order derivative, right? Hence here the objective is to find the minimum of the criterion function given by c, which is equal to the Laplacian operator. So similar to the Wiener filter, here also we minimize this error term with respect to f, but subject to the constraint shown here. So we know that this c is the operator that we have to choose, and this is nothing but a high pass filter or Laplacian filter. So here the constraint tells us that the energy is imposed by the norm of the restored image at high frequencies is below this threshold, and this means that we do not allow arbitrary high frequency fluctuations in the output image. So we can say that this imposes a smoothness requirement on the solution. And we know from the drawbacks of Wiener filter that it smooths out image more than what human eye would prefer. So that problem is solved here. This equation is derived directly from this equation. Here g is our degraded image, h is the degradation function, f cap is our estimate of the original image, and n is the noise, where norm of w square is equal to w transpose into w, which is the Euclidean vector norm. So this is the optimization problem, and the frequency domain solution to this optimization problem is given by this expression. See, this equation is same as the equation for Wiener filter, which we have learned in the previous video class. Just the difference over here is in place of SN by SF, we have introduced P of UV, which is our constraint. And hence, in this equation, you can see that we do not need any knowledge of the power spectra. In this equation, P of UV is the Fourier transform of P of XY, which is nothing but the Laplacian operator or Laplacian filter mask, which we have already studied earlier. And gamma is the parameter that must be adjusted so that this constraint is satisfied. Now, using an example of a test image, let us understand the performance of CLS filter as well as the MMSE filter or the Wiener filter. So, this is a test image that is degraded by motion blur as well as Gaussian noise, having variance of 650, 325 and 130. So, when the noise is very high, you can see that the result of CLS filter is good as compared to the Wiener filter. Here, the image is more clear. When the noise variance is 325, you can see still the CLS filter is performing better as compared to the Wiener filter. And when the noise variance is 130, the result that is obtained by CLS filter as well as MMSE or Wiener filter is almost same. So this shows that the CLS filter performs better when the noise is higher as compared to the Wiener filter, and when the noise is low, both performs almost equally. So for the CLSF, we have to adjust the gamma until we get the acceptable results, and this gamma must be adjusted so that the constraint is satisfied. So this is the procedure to adjust gamma. First, we define a residual vector R, which is equal to G minus HF, and it can be shown that phi of gamma is equal to R transpose into R, which is norm of R square. So here we want to adjust gamma so that norm of R square is equal to norm of N square plus or minus A, where A is our accuracy factor. So these are the steps. Number one, we specify an initial value of gamma. Number two, we will compute the R square. Number three, we will stop if number one is satisfied, that is R square is equal to N square plus or minus A is satisfied. Otherwise, we will return to step two after increasing gamma if R square is less than N square minus A, or decreasing gamma if R square is greater than N square plus A. And we will use the new value of gamma to recompute F cap of UV, which is equal to H star UV upon modulus of H of UV whole square plus of gamma into modulus of P of UV whole square into G of UV. And this is the final equation that we obtain. So these are the steps for adjusting gamma. Finally, let us compare the constraint least square filter versus the MMSE minimum mean square error filter or the Wiener filter. So Wiener filter is optimal in the average sense, while CLSF yields optimal result to each image to which it is applied. This means that Wiener filter will provide us the average result to every image that we apply, while the CLS filter will provide us the best or most favorable result. Next, when noise is low, both Wiener filter and CLS filter generate equal results. But when the noise is high, the CLS filter is advantageous as compared to the Wiener filter if proper gamma is selected. Why? Because it is easier to select the scalar value of gamma rather than to approximate the K, which is Sn by Sf, which is never constant. Why? Because noise is a random noise. Getting it, right? So from this discussion, we can conclude that the CLS filter removes the drawbacks of Wiener filter, and in general, the manual adjustment of filter parameters provides us better output. Let us implement this CLS filter in MATLAB. This is the MATLAB program for constraint least square filtering, and this program is similar to the program that we have already seen for the Wiener filter. So if you have not seen that, you can refer to the previous video class. As usual, we are reading an image and plotting in one of the subplots. Then we are forming a point spread function of motion blur and blurring our image A and naming it A blurred using IM filter. The noise mean we are choosing is 0. Noise variance is 0.0001. Signal variance is given by variance of the original image, and noise to signal ratio is given by noise variance upon signal variance. So now we will be adding the noise to our blurred image, and hence our image will be consisting of blur as well as noise, which we will call blurred plus noisy image. Now for the Wiener filter, we were using deconv Wiener. Here for the CLS filter, we have to use deconv regular. The CLS filter is implemented in MATLAB by deconv regular or deconvolution regular blurred plus noisy image point spread function NSR, and we can even specify the range. So here the noise power is proportional to norm of N square, and the range is the range of values where the algorithm is limited to look for a solution for gamma. The default values of range, which we have not provided over here, is 10 raised to minus 9 to 10 raised to plus 9. And if we are not specifying NSR parameter as well as the range parameter, which we have not specified over here, then this deconvolution regular produces an inverse filter solution. So let us run the program and see the output. So this is our original image. This is image that is blurred as well as having additive white Gaussian noise. And when we use the CLS filter, this is the restored image that we obtain. And you can see that the restored image is an acceptable result of the original image. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. Thank you very much.